So in this video, we will study about the posterior interosseous nerve, which is an important nerve of the forearm. So as we have studied about the anterior interosseous nerve, which is a branch of median nerve, posterior interosseous nerve is a branch of the radial nerve. And as the name indicates, it is in the posterior compartment, which is the extensor compartment or the dorsal compartment of the forearm. So it is a motor branch of the radial nerve. It originates radial nerve at the level of elbow joint, just distal to the elbow joint. Divides into two parts. It divides into superficial radial nerve, which is the cutaneous branch, sensory branch, and it divides into the deep radial nerve, which is the posterior interosseous nerve, which is a mainly a motor branch. So course of the nerve, it after the origin from the radial nerve, it passes between the two heads of the supinator muscle. So supinator muscle, so as we can see here, so after the origin from the, so at the level of elbow joint, the radial nerve divides into the superficial radial nerve and the deep radial nerve. So deep radial nerve is the posterior interosseous nerve, which passes between the two heads of the supinator muscles. So after passing between the two heads of the supinator muscle, it goes more deeper and lies over the deeper extensor muscle, which is the abductor pollicis longus, which is a part of the deeper extensor compartment. And it reaches more deeper to lie over the interosseous membrane, which is a membrane between the radius and the ulna. So after passing between the supinator muscle, it goes deeper and distally over the deep extensor muscle, more deeper and distally over the interosseous membrane. And it ends at the level of the elbow joint, providing the sensory supply to the dorsal wrist capsule. So it is mainly a motor branch, but it does supply sensory supply to the dorsal wrist capsule. And it does not have any cutaneous innervation. So in all the muscles that are supplied, so we should know the basic, all the muscles of the extensor compartment, all the layers of the extensor compartment. So in motor, in superficial extensor, we have the four muscles which are supplied by the posterior interosseous nerve. ECRB is sometimes supplied by the posterior interosseous nerve, and many times it is supplied by the radial nerve itself. So we can have supply to the ECRB, extensor carpi radialis brevis, then other muscle of the superficial extensor compartment of the forearm, extensor digiti communis, extensor digiti minimi, and extensor digiti ulnaris. This is extensor digiti ulnaris. And then the deep extensor compartment, we have the muscular motor supply to the supinator muscle, abductor pollicis longus, extensor pollicis brevis, extensor pollicis longus, and extensor indices propriae. So these are the muscles. So basically it supplies all the extensor compartment muscles except the two muscles, which is the brachioradialis and the extensor carpi radialis longus, which are supplied by the radial nerve itself. Now we will study about the various sites of compression of the radial nerve. So it is compressed at the level of the elbow joint after the origin. So we can have various causes of the compression of the posterior interosseous nerve. So first cause is the fibrous tissue, any tissue which is lies anterior to the radiocapitular joint. So any fibrous tissue which is anterior to the radiocapitular joint will lead to compression of the posterior interosseous nerve. Then there is a leash of Henry, which is the, so this is the leash of Henry, this is the various branches from the radial artery, which are known as the recurrent radial arteries. So these are the leash, various branches which are at this level, providing supply to the brachioradialis, which may lead to compression of the posterior interosseous nerve at this level. Then we can have a compression by the ECRB edge. So we have the ECRB muscle here. So the edge of the ECRB can lead to compression of the posterior interosseous nerve. And finally is the arcade of the fossae. So arcade of fossae is the superficial edge of the supinator muscle. So this is the arcade of fossae, which is the superficial edge of the supinator muscle. So these are the various regions because of which the posterior interosseous nerve can be compressed at the elbow joint. Now what all signs and symptoms it will produce? So among the symptoms, the patient may complain of the pain in the forearm and the wrist and the elbow joint. And in chronic cases, there may be a atrophy of the extensor muscles. And in signs, so as we know that all the extensor compartment, they cause extension of the wrist and the MCP joint. So extension of the wrist is caused by the extensor compartment muscles and the extension of the MCP joint. So peculiar feature in posterior interosseous nerve is that the MCP joint extension is lost. So extension of IP joint is caused by the lumbricals and interossei, which are intact. The MCP joint extension is lost, which is caused by the extensor communis, extensor digiti minimi, extensor indices. So this is lost. About the wrist extension, so wrist extension is basically caused by the brachioradialis, ECRL, ECRB and ECU, extensor carpi ulnaris. So in this case, the ECRB and ECU are gone. So patient will be able to dorsiflex the wrist, but it will be in a radial deviation. Because on radial side, we have the attachment of brachioradialis and ECRL, which are intact. But ECU, which is on the ulnar side, it is lost. So patient will be able to dorsiflex, but it will be in a radial deviation. So there will be weakness in the dorsiflexion. While the MCP joint extension will be completely lost, wrist joint extension will be in the radial deviation. So these are the various signs and symptoms. Among the investigations, we can go for the NCV and EMG studies. We can go for the MRI to look for any space occupying lesion or any of these component that is causing compression. In treatment part, so firstly we will go for the non-operative management in the form of the activity modification, stretching, splinting and anti-inflammatory drugs. So if after 3 months of the non-operative treatment, there is no relief in the or there is no progression of the there is still progression of the signs and symptoms, so we can go for the surgical decompression. In surgical decompression, we will go for the anterolateral approach of the elbow and will cause removal of the all the compression causes. So that was about the posterior interosseous nerve. So summarizing it, so these are the various causes of the compression of the posterior interosseous nerve. We have the first, any fibrous tissue which is at the level of the radiocapital joint. Second is the leash of Henry, the recurrent radial arteries causing compression of the pin. Third is the arcade of Frochet, which is the superior edge or superficial edge of the supinator muscle. Fourth is the distal edge of the supinator muscle may also cause. And fifth is the edge of the ECRB. So this can cause the compression. And important in the course is the it lies between the two heads of the supinator muscles. So it is deep to the supinator muscle and superficial radial nerve is superficial to the supinator muscle. So thank you.